bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. This is Back to the Bible, another segment of the Sinner's Pride video. The Sinner's Pride videos, as you know, is meant that we know how loving and merciful this Father that we serve is. And, you know, it also keeps us, takes us back to the Bible to read the Bible verses. Amen. Today in the Sinner's Pride, I want us to study something from the book of Luke, chapter 18. Luke chapter 18. You know, it begins where Jesus Christ was telling or teaching that man ought to pray and not faint, you know, that we should be persistent in our prayer. And the Bible says Jesus gave a scenario about a judge who was not God-fearing. He neither feared God nor man, so he was like a wicked judge, so to speak. And the Bible said there was a widow who had done something wrong, and the widow would go to a judge to plead for mercy. And the Bible said the judge wouldn't listen, but the widow kept persisting. And the judge said to himself that, you know, if I don't avenge to this widow, if I don't show mercy to this widow, she will keep troubling me. And the Bible said the judge showed the widow mercy. So Jesus over here was talking about how persistent that we should be in prayer. He was teaching us to be fervent in our prayer, to be persistent in our prayer. So listen, the widow, even though by her name, a widow, someone that has lost a husband, you know, even though she was a widow, she was a victim of a scenario, she was also a culprit. She had done something wrong. There was something that she needed mercy, you know. There was something that had gone wrong on her side. So there are so many people that even though you might be struggling, even though, yes, something might be going wrong, but there is something that you might have done wrong. And so Jesus was trying to teach us that, don't just look at how painful, you know, you are or whatever you might be going through, but just also consider some of your mistakes and go to the Father and persistently, you know, pray to him, seek his face, and he'll be merciful to you. And Jesus was also trying to let us know that no matter how your sin is, if you can persist in prayer, yes, you might be going through some of the troubles that come with your mistake, but by your persistence and fervency in prayer, the Lord will be merciful to you. Amen. Okay, now, after he had given that scenario, he gave a parable. And that starts from verse 9 of Luke 18. When we read verse 9 of Luke 18, Jesus said there were two men, a Pharisee, which is a believer, a Christian, and a publican, an unbeliever or a sinner. And they both went into the church. You know, a publican is a tax collector. You know, in life, everybody hates to pay tax, no matter how rich anybody is, they don't want to pay tax, but everybody wants to profit. So a tax collector would work with the government, you know, and you know, put some levy or put some certain amount on the taxes that the government originally charges. So they would, you know, to the tax collector, they would be making profit. But because nobody wants to pay tax, they saw them as sinners. But this is a tax collector, a sinner, a publican, who found himself in a church. He had gone into the church to pray. Amen. And so this is a prayer. Oh, Jesus was talking about prayers. And he was giving a scenario of two prayers. One of a self-righteous man. A man who thinks he is perfect. A man who despises the other people. A man who thinks they are a Christian, they are righteous people, and others are sinners, you know. And he said a prayer that, Father, you know, I pay my tithe, you know, I sow my seed, you know, I am a perfect guy, I'm a righteous guy, I'm a Christian, I'm a servant, da 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 da. And so I deserve the good things from you. And the publican or the tax collector or the sinner said a simple prayer. He said, Father, I am a sinner. I don't deserve any good thing from you. Show me mercy. And the Bible says, the one, Jesus specifically said, the one who thought he was self-righteous went, you know, he went his way unjust. He went his way and without the mercy of God. But the one who said a prayer, the Father, the one who admitted that they were a sinner, Jesus accepted them. The Lord heard the sinner's prayer, the publican's prayer. What is this trying to teach us? If you remember, the Bible says in Chronicles, 2 Chronicles 7:40, that if my people that are called by my name will humble themselves and pray to seek my face, I, the Lord, will hear them from heaven, and, you know, I'll forgive them and heal their land. So number one, this is a publican, a sinner. He entered, he went, he made a step. He went into the house of God to pray. And he was not, you know, this is someone, usually they are worthy people, people that are rich. But he was so humble. He was so humble to tell God the Father, I am nothing without you. Be merciful to me. And indeed, Jesus, the Lord, heard his prayer. He is the sinner's prayer. It doesn't matter what you have done wrong. It doesn't matter how righteous, how self-righteous you think you may be. It doesn't matter how sinful your ways might be. All it takes is that you will humble yourself, go before the Lord and cry out to him that, Abba Father, I accept that I am a sinner. Forgive me and be merciful to me. And indeed, he, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, being the sinner's prayer, will hear you and answer you. Now bless you. Go back to the Bible and read the book of Luke chapter
8. Consuming fire, burn it away, burn it away. Consuming fire, consuming fire, burn it away.